गुड मॉर्निंग चिल्ड्रन, हैव अ नाइस डे। स्टैंडर्ड 9th, ज्योग्राफी, यूनिट 4, हाइड्रोस्फीयर। वी नो दैट आवर प्लैनेट अर्थ कंसिस्ट ऑफ 4 स्फीयर्स। दे आर द लिथोस्फीयर, एटमॉस्फीयर, हाइड्रोस्फीयर एंड बायोस्फीयर। इन द अर्लियर चैप्टर्स वी हैव स्टडीड अबाउट द लिथोस्फीयर एंड एटमॉस्फीयर। We shall now learn other two spheres, namely the hydrosphere and the biosphere. Hydrosphere. One of the indispensable natural resources on Earth is water. The Earth is also is called the blue planet, as it holds water in abundance and thus this stands unique among all other planets. Hydrosphere. Hydrospheres consist of water in various the forms the found on the Earth. Over 97% of the water on Earth's surface is confined to ocean. Less than 3% of water is held on land as glaciers, ice caps, groundwater, rivers, lakes, and also as the water vapor in air. So next discuss a topic, hydrological cycle. The earth water is not static. It is always in motion. This continuous movement of water on above and below the earth's surface is called the hydrological cycle. The three major processes involved in the water cycle are evaporation, condensation and precipitation. These are the three major processes. Water changes its form constantly, that is ice, water and water vapor. This process happen in blink of an eye or even over million of years. Water resource of earth can be broadly divided into fresh water, another one salt water. So first discuss a topic, fresh water. Rainwater is considered to be the purest form of water, as it contains very less proportion of the salt when compared to the oceans and seas. Hence, it is called fresh water. A major part of fresh water is found in the frozen state in the form of ice caps and glaciers. Around 1% of it is found in the liquid state as rivers, streams, lakes, ponds, etc. Surface water may also penetrate through pores, rocks and gets collected beneath the earth's surface. This is called groundwater. Next, it's a fact. It's a very important one. It's a Finland. The Finland is known as the land of 1,000 lakes. How many lakes, children? Land of 1,000 lakes. There are 187,888 lakes in Finland. So next, another one, do you know? Water table. Water table is a level below the ground where water is found collected beneath the earth's surface. Aquifers are porous rocks strata filled with water. The fawn blow the earth surface. So next discuss the topic, oceans. The continents and oceans are however not evenly distributed in the northern and the southern hemispheres. The northern hemispheres hold 61% of the land, whereas the southern hemisphere holds 81% of water. It is because of this pattern of land and water distribution. The northern hemisphere is called the land hemisphere. So northern hemisphere is called what, children? Land hemisphere. The southern hemisphere is called as a water hemisphere. The southern hemisphere is called what, children? It's a water and hemisphere. So oceans and seas are considered as resource blow of the earth because of immense availability of food, minerals, etc. Present distribution of the worlds and oceans and major the seas are illustrated in the map. So next, do you know this Sylvia Early is a famous American oceanographer. She was named as the first hero of the planet by the Time magazine of her efforts towards marine life protections. Next, Jacques Cousteau, 1910-1997, was a famous French ocean explorer who conducted extensive under-the-sea investigations. He belonged to the information service of the French Navy and was sent on missions to Shanghai and Japan 1935 and 1938 and in the USSR 1939. The Honors, the Cross of the War 1939-1945, the US Presidential Medal of the Freedom 1985. So next, discuss a topic, relief of the ocean floor. The ocean basins are characteristic by the following major relief features: continental shelf, continental slope, continental rise, deep sea plain or abyssal plain, oceanic deep and oceanic ridge. So let us recall this point. So what is a hydrosphere? Hydrological cycle, freshwater, oceans. So we will discuss next class. Thank you, children.